Hey, I'm Princess Naya, and right now you're locked into Link Up TV presents A Day in the Life. First thing in the morning I do is I wake up around 4:55, well, that's the time my alarm's set for. I jump up and I go for a 20-minute cardio run at 5 a.m. People do think I'm crazy when they see me running at 5 o'clock in the morning. And then after my 5 o'clock run, I run for like 20 minutes, which is just under 3 miles. I get home and jump in the shower, and then I look over my goals and stuff for the year, and then I basically plan what I'm going to do that day. And then depending on how I'm getting into the office or where I'm going, I either jump in my car, or if I'm on the tube, then I'll read a book, something inspirational, something that inspires. I normally arrive at work at around 7 o'clock. I like to beat the morning rush. The sardines thing on the tube is really crazy, so I try to avoid that by any means necessary. I'll get in at 7, I have my porridge, some green tea, and yeah, I just sit down and I look at everything that's going on in the particular business that day, depending what day it is, and then yeah, I get ready for the day. I'm the man of the family. Penny's where my dad. We do team meetings in the office weekly. We do them on a Tuesday morning. The reason why I like to do team meetings is because I think that it's really important for us as a team to have like morale. Like, I remember working at a work experience place years ago, and I basically just made cups of tea and done general work experience things. And then when I worked at Foot Locker, I was introduced to this real big American team spirit type vibe, and training was really, really important. And what I noticed while I was there is that if you train and motivate, people have a really good day at work regardless of what they're doing. So for me, I just feel like it's really important. And also it allows me to tap into all the different creative sectors that my team want to be involved in. And then that way I can kind of try and help them follow their dreams as well as them helping me build mine. At Beans Boutique, we do loads of different stuff. Sometimes, for the majority of the time, we're doing photo shoots. We're always brand developing. Everyone in the office has a part to play in every different aspect of what we do. So whether or not it's the designing and then bringing it to life and then actually photographing it and getting it on the screen, like, all of us play a really important part in that, which is really, really important to me. Like, we actually do in-house photography, in-house editing. Everything is done by someone who works in the office. A lot of people ask me, are you still doing music? I think that it probably looks like I just go to Beans Boutique every day and work 150 hours, when the reality is that as much time as I spend in the boutique is as much time as I spend on my music. So from the office, I pack up and I leave and I go to studio, and yeah, I record music. I still believe even when you don't. They always leave when you're on a low. You should be afraid of a woman like me. I record myself probably nearly every day. I have a setup at home where I write and I record demos. And so yeah, I record nearly every day. I think that I learned that from my mentor, Angela Hunt, who's a big songwriter. When I stayed with her for a short period of time, I noticed that she wrote every single day. She recorded tracks maybe 3 times a day. It was just normal to her.
Naya, you work so hard. From the first day I met you, I befriended you, and I wanted to know who you were, because I wanted to know who was this black woman that had her own business, and she was working so hard to maintain a career as an artist, a businesswoman. I had never seen that in London, and I just applaud you so much. I think I should give Naya a big round of applause.
For the past year, I've been working with a producer from Wolverhampton. He's called TRC. We have an amazing chemistry. He's like the brother that I didn't have, which is really weird. We have a lot of fun. The distance in between us, because he's in Wolverhampton and because I'm in London, that's the reason why I've got a studio set up at home, because I record demos and I send them over to him, he'll listen to them, he'll send them back, he'll be like, I'll change this. And then when we get in the studio, we just record everything that we've been working on remotely. And he's really busy, like I'm really busy. So we have a lot of fun poking fun at each other, because it's like we're too busy for each other, but we make it happen and it's really good. Been like to touch my toes when I'm raving. Having my own label, was a really conscious decision that I made in 2010. I wanted to be able to release my own music. Back then, I kind of feel like I was on my own. Whereas now, I'm really fortunate to have a really great team. I have a team of people that are working alongside me. Not only are they working with me, but I feel like they're like, they really believe in everything that I'm doing, and it makes my life so much more easier. I have so many different things to do. Not having a direct manager, is not that much of a problem, because I have so many individuals around me that are amazing at what they do, and they bring their talents and their attributes into my life and help me roll out what I want to roll out in the best way possible. So yeah, the team, they're amazing. You want a hero? Well, I'm a villain. I get asked to do a lot of guest speaking, and this fits into my day almost every single week. I really enjoy it. I do it as much as I can without letting my other businesses suffer. Sometimes it's really difficult to pluck myself out of a day where I've got 6 hours in the office with my guys, and then I've got another 6 hours that I need to do in the studio. I try to fit it in where I can, you know, but I really, really do love it. I think that it's really important to speak to young people and people in general who want to get into business and tell them my story, because I'm still on my journey, and I feel like if I can explain to them all the way, places and things that I've done and the way I've done things wrong however many times, I think that it's a really good way to let them know that the journey to being an entrepreneur or someone in the creative industry, it's not an easy straight road. There's loads of dips and hurdles to jump, but I'm still here. So if I can do it, then I'm sure you can do it too. For me, I think that aside from being in the studio, performing is something that I really love and enjoy. The rehearsal part of it is something that I really love and enjoy also. It's a time where I can try out different things, I can practice new material, I can do cover stuff, I can even just sing along to songs that I like. I mean, the other day I was playing a whole leap of different artists, and nothing to do with my set, but in the creative process and the rehearsal process, it's a part that I really, really enjoy. Going on to the performance side of things, I think that any performer would tell you that they love performing, especially when the crowd know your songs, because you feel like you really connected. I wrote Frontline in the bathroom of one of the producers' house in 2008 in Harlesden, and I don't think for one second me recording that song in that bathroom with all the feedback did I ever think that I would perform in places like, you know, local community festivals to Wembley Arena and have everybody singing back my lyrics that I wrote in my car. So yeah, it's an amazing feeling, and I can't wait to perform my new music. Work, 5 a.m. I'm running. I keep myself motivated by surrounding myself with positive people, and also reading stories of other people that have been in similar positions to myself, people that are on the come up, people that are starting businesses, people that have tried 1,000 times and failed but then didn't ever quit, and they made it that last hurdle by just keep pushing. So that's how I keep motivated. I think it's really, you know, reading books and reading autobiographies is a really cool way to find out what other people have done without actually having to have met them. So that's what I do to stay motivated. A lot of people ask me, what do I do for fun, like what do I do in my spare time, and I feel like I'm really spoiled because I get the best of both worlds, because I come into my office or I go to the studio, I'm at rehearsals, I'm at a team meeting, I'm planning, and I'm doing all of these things that are things that people dream of doing, you know, and for me that is, it's just so much fun. On the flip side to that, I do loads of normal stuff, you know, I hang out with my girls and we drink wine, poke fun at people at the bar, and I watch trash TV, and I spend a lot of time with my family. Like, I love spending time with my nan and granddad and listening to stories of when they were my age. Christmas, everybody's having fun. Let's get them every morning. The best part of my journey is the fact that I'm still here. Still feel like I've got a lot to achieve and a long way to go, but I haven't given up, and that is the best part. I still have as much passion as I did when I first ever set up my first business and I first started recording. I have the same amount of passion and drive as I did then that I do now, and for that I'm really grateful.
I'ma keep it moving, said I'ma keep it moving. Dreams never die, so a nightmare doesn't faze me.